Okay, we are connecting now. And okay, let's continue our discussion today. Can you hear my voice and my slide clearly? Hello? Can you hear my voice and
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, this is chapter 6 about linear transformation. And we begin our discussion with the definition of linear transformation. In this definition say that a function in the form of a linear equation that maps vectors in Rn become a vector in, sorry. It's a mistake here. Okay, a function in the form of a linear equation that maps vectors in Rn become vectors in Rm. That is T. So we call T as linear transformation from Rn to Rm. Because all of function is a linear equation, so we can make the equation become this symbols T from Rn to Rm defined by equation of forms like this. There are m equations and there are n variables. X1, X2, up to Xn. If we make it simpler, we have this form. We know it as a matrix notation form. So we make A11 up to AMn become a matrix size m times n, and the variables in the right x1 x2 and xn, and the x1 x2 and xn is the independence variable, and y1 w1 w2 and wm are dependent variables. So we have this notation, or in short we make like this: w vector w is equal to a times vector x. And also because we know as a function t, so T represented by T is represented by A, and matrix A is called a standard matrix of T. Next, we will find the matrix standard of linear transformation. Sorry, this is a linear transformation from R5 to R3, and it means that there are three dependent variables and there are five independent variables, and we have matrix A size 3 times 5. Okay, how we can find the matrix standard? We can write like this. Okay. We can write like this, genetic standard of T in this case. We have W1 is equal to 2x1 minus 3x2. Oh, sorry, I don't need to repeat it. And I will continue by using matrix notation form W1, W2, and W3. Then in the middle, we have a matrix size 3 times 5, 2 here, and minus 3, 1, 0, minus 5. And in the second line, we have 4, 1, minus 2, 0 also, 1. And in the third line, we have 5, minus 1, 0, 4, 0. And this matrix multiplied by x1, x2, up to x5. So in this case, we know it factor W. This is matrix A, size 3 times 5. And in the right, we have factor X. This is our equation. And our answer is A. So the standard matrix for T is 2 minus 3, 1, 0, minus 5, 4, 1, minus 2, 0, 1, and 5, minus 1, 0, 4, 0. Here is our answer. It's easy, I think. You just need to know what numbers in the right, in the domain, and what number dimension what numbers in the left, in the left in the domain, and what numbers in the right, in the range, in the range. This is a domain, and the right is range. So this is what we need. Okay, we can continue with the types of linear transformation. There are 4 types of linear transformation, and also we have a limitation with our linear transformation. In the beginning, we talk about Rn to Rm. Now we will limit our discussion become Rn to Rn, and usually we can say linear transformation in this case, transformation become operators. So a linear transformation is a general forms. In the specific forms, if we have Rn to Rn, and then our linear transformation can be called as operator. And there are four types of operators we will discuss. The first, we will discuss about expansion and contraction. Second, we will discuss about projection. Third, we will discuss about reflection. And the last, we will discuss about rotation. Now we will discuss about expansion and contraction. I'm sorry, I can't find the table in English. So I still copy from Indonesian from Bahasa. This is expansion, or in Bahasa we say pelebaran, and contraction in Bahasa we said penyempitan. And we will discuss first in two dimension or in R2. This is the contraction. Contraction means that we shorten our previous vectors become shorter like this. This is our initial vectors, and this is the result. W shorter than vector x, and the equation for these operators W1 is equal to Qx, W2 is equal to Qy, and Q is the vector. Q is a vector, and the value of Q from 0 to 1. So we make it shorter. And what about expansion? Expansion is opposite of contraction. In the expansion, we make our vector longer than before. This is our initial vectors, and W is longer than X. The equation the equation for expansion and contraction is the same, and also they have a same metric standard. A standard matrix, but the value is different. In the contraction, the value of Q between 0 and 1, but in the expansion, the value of Q larger than 1. What about Q is equal to 1? It means that W is X itself. I think it's simple. I think it's because you just need what kind of your operator contraction or expansion, and you just need what is the number of key. After you know the number of key, you can put in this matrix. This is the standard matrix of expansion and contraction. And now, what about in three dimension or R3? In the three dimension, the same principle. I think the same way in the two dimension. The different only the variable will be three variables. In two dimension only two variables. We have W1, W2, and W3, and W1 is equal to key X, and W2 is equal to key Y, and W3 is equal to key Z. So we have a metric, a standard matrix, size 3 times 3, where key is in the main diagonal. And the number of key depend on what kind of our operator, contraction or expansion. Okay, I think so the first operators is quite easy, I think, because the standard matrix is simple. Okay, then we will discuss about the second operator, projection. Projection. Projection means that we look at our vectors orthogonally respect to onto the specific axis. For example, we have a vector X, and we look at the vectors orthogonally onto x-axis. So we have, this is our projection, and we say it Tx. And Tx, the formula of Tx is x is equal to x, so there is no difference between in the x value, the value of x, but for y, we make it zero because our vectors lie on x axis now. So we have that this situation where our standard matrix will be 1 0 0 0. So it look like identity, but in the last component, the value of last component is zero. And also, we can project our vector x onto the y axis, such that our y is constant, but our value of x become a zero. So this is the formula of orthogonal projection onto the y axis, and this is our standard matrix. We have zero in the beginning of our components, and only one in the last component. Yeah, this is for
So,
yeah. What happened?
if it's zero on the left or the right, it means that both of them is zero, so?
Pardon, I can hear you.
So if x and y is zero, both of them, it means all of them is zero, is it so?
Sorry. I can understand. Can you?
I did so.
Huh? Pardon? Yeah, you can write. Can you write it? Oh yeah. Can you? Yeah. Please write it. If both x and y is zero, so then all of them is zero. You means these factors, both of them zero mean in this the factors of the zero factors. What do you mean by both of x and y is zero? I mean tx. No. For projection, we must project onto. This is the requirement. We must project onto spatial axis. So, yeah, we will be one of them must be zero. It cannot be happen. It cannot be happen because we project it orthogonally, so cannot be happen in this case. How to say it? This is look like identity, isn't it? If you have this linear transformation, it means that W is equal to X and W1, W2 is equal to Y. So you will have that W1, W2 is equal to 1, 0, 0, 1. X and Y. So your standard matrix will be 1, 0, 0, 1. So this is not projection. This is identity. What do you think? Lalu kita.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yes, sir. Maybe.
Yeah, because the orthogonal projection must be project it onto a specific axis, so must be one of them or must be zero. For this is project onto y axis, and in the top project onto the x axis. So we can do like this for projection. This is not projection. Okay, yeah, maybe you have some understanding, later. Please continue, and if you still have any confusion, and you can text me again. Okay, let's we continue our discussion and our projection in three dimension. We have three ways. Maybe we have other projection, not only this, but in this discussion, we have only three kinds of projection. The first is if we have vector x in three dimension and we project it onto xy plane. So this is xy plane, and our projection is in the xy plane. And the other, we have x in three dimension, and we project it onto the
Hello.
So if we project onto the xy plane, our z will become zero because our projection will be in the xy plane. And for projection onto xz plane, our y become zero because our projection in the xz plane. This is xz plane. And the third, we project it onto yz plane. This is yz plane, the parallel with our slide. Here, our vector x, if we project onto yz plane, the value of x will be zero because we are in yz plane. And this is the formula. If we make the formula like this, x and w is equal to y and w3 is equal to zero. So if we make it become matrix notation, and we will have w1, w2, and w3 will be 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0, and this is x y z, and it means that our standard matrix is like in the table. Okay, so for orthogonal projection onto xz plane, we can do the same way. W1 is equal to x, W2 is equal to 0, and W3 is equal to z. And then we have the W1, W2, and W3 is equal to 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 1, and this is multiplied by x y z. So the standard matrix is in the second. Okay, it means that you must know what happened to the function, and after that you must get the standard matrix. And also in the this, we have W1 is equal to 0, W2 is equal to y, W3 is equal to z. And our matrix, our standard metric is like this: 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. Do you have any question from now until now? We have already talked about expansion and contraction, and we have already talked about projection in this contraction and expansion. We have two dimension and three dimension. For projection also we have two dimension and three dimension. In two dimension we project onto x axis, and in also y axis we project into x axis and y axis. In three dimension we project into z xy axis and xz axis, and the last we project onto y z axis. This is the metric. The standard metric is key 0, 0 key, and three dimension the standard metric is key 0, 0, 0 key 0, 0, 0 key. Okay, and two dimension you have 0, 1, 0, 0, and this is 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, this is also have a specific matrix in this x, y, z is 0, so 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. For xz axis, y becomes 0, so we will have 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. In the yz axis, we have x will be 0, so our standard metric is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. So in the end you must know what is the standard matrix for each of records. So this is the standard matrix. You can memorize it. Its operators have a specific standard metric. Okay, we will continue to reflection. This is the reflection. Reflection means that we make a mirror. We make a mirror or a shadow of for x respect to x axis or y axis, or maybe we make a shadow respect to the line y is equal to x. This is the reflection about x-axis. Our vector x, then we make a shadow respect to x. This is our shadow, dx, our shadow, and we can look at that our y will be minus y, and x will be constant. There is no difference value of x. So we have that w1 is equal to x, still x, and w2 is equal to minus y. And we have that w1, w2, and it means that 1, 0, 0, minus 1, minus 1, x, y. And this is our standard matrix. Standard matrix for reflection about x axis. And what about reflection about y axis? We have that the value of y is equal, but the value of x will be minus x. Then this is the operators, and by using the same way in the previous, we have that w1, w2 is equal to minus x, is equal to y, and we have that the standard matrix become this minus x will be in the first row, the first row, different with the reflection about x axis, minus in the second row. So what about our mirror? Line y is equal to x by using geometric properties. If we have this mirror, we can look at that our vectors become reverse position. X become y become x. So this is our formula, reflection about the line w, y is equal to x, the line w, y is equal to x. So we have that w1 is equal to y and w2 is equal to x. And then we make W1, W2 is equal to 0, 1, 0. And this is x, because we must multiply y by 1 in the first row. So our standard matrix for reflection about the line y is equal to x is 0, 1, 1, 0. Maybe we have other kinds of reflection, but in this lecture, we just mention three kinds of reflection in two dimension. Yeah, you can ask what about the reflection about the line of y is equal minus x? What happened? We have x. And what happened with the shadow? So it's beyond our discussion. We talk only reflection about x axis, y axis, and the line y is equal to x. This is beyond our discussion. We talk only three kinds of reflection operator in two dimension. And now in three dimension. In three dimension, we can reflect our vectors about the plan. Yeah, we have three plan: xy, xz, and yz. So this is our reflection, our initial vector, and after reflection, we have that that become minus z. So our reflection make w1 is equal to x, still x, w2 is equal to y, w3 is equal to minus z. And our standard metric will be like this. It equal to identity matrix except the last component must be minus one. And reflection about xz plane, it means that the value of y become minus y, and x and z are the same. So you can make or look at that w1 is x is equal to x, w2 is equal to minus y, and w3 is equal to z, and you will have the standard matrix of reflection about xz plane is like this. It's the same with the identity, similar to identity, except the second line must be minus one. And also for the last reflection about yz plane, we have that the first line must be minus one. So you can memorize easier by looking at that the standard matrix of reflection operator in three dimension similar to identity, except one of them must be minus one. Okay, there is how to do it in SymboLab. In SymboLab, we must memorize we must memorize the standard matrix. So in SymboLab, we just do multiplication of matrix. There is no like what we call encyclopedia. In SymboLab, there is no illustration. SymboLab only using solution. It means that by using algebra. No, there is no illustration. For illustration, you can use GeoGebra. GeoGebra, you can find the illustration using illustration of objects. You can use GeoGebra. SymboLab only for solution or doing algebra manipulation. Okay, I will do some exercise by using Simulab later, but we can illustrate that we just find the solution. Okay, look at the last operator. In this operator, we talk about a rotation. Rotation means that we move our vectors become new vectors by using an angle. There is an angle thing. Okay, look at how to move x. This is our initial vector x, and we move our vectors become new vectors by using a specific angle. And we can move our vectors in two dimension. Yeah? In two dimension, we can move our vector two way, counterclockwise or clockwise. Yeah? This is counterclockwise, and this is clockwise. It's clockwise. Counterclockwise. If we use counterclockwise, it means that our angle will be positive. So our theta, the value of our theta will be positive. But if we use clockwise, so our value of theta will be minus. This is the agreement, yeah, the agreement in mathematics. If we make a movement counterclockwise, so our angle will be positive. But if we make a movement clockwise, our angle will be negative. So this is a agreement, yeah, agreement, and we must follow it. So what is the standard matrix of rotation in two dimension? This is the standard matrix. How to find it? I think we just use it. Don't need to make a proof to find this formula. We just only use it. Yeah? This is our standard matrix for rotation. And look at the pattern. Diagonal will be cosine theta, and the other diagonal will be sine theta, but the value of sine plus in the second line and minus in the first line. This is the standard matrix for rotation counterclockwise. And theta say about angle to move our vector, initial vector become a result vector. And what about three dimension? In three dimension, in three dimension, we have a story about it, how to understand the movement in three dimension. I will I will make it I will repeat the illustration to make it clear for you. This is our initial vector x, and we will move these vectors with the what we call with the titik tumpu, what should we say, and we move the terminal. This is initial point, and this is the terminal point, and we move these vectors around specific axis. In this case, we move our vectors around z axis. Yeah, and our the angle, the angle of our movement, this the angle to move around specific axis, in this case z axis. Yeah, look at the example. Here our initial vector x, and then we move x about 180, 100, for example, yeah, or 180 degree counterclockwise, and we have the n the result vector in this position, and this is our new vectors. We say it W vectors. And now we look at the x, the coordinates of x, y, and z from the vector x become new coordinate w1, w2, and w3. Okay. Because we just only make a movement around z axis, so our value of z will be the same. Yeah. It means that we will have that W1, W2, and this is Z, because the height of vectors Z will be same with the height of W. So the value of z will be the same. And now we must find W1 and W2. What is the value of W1 and W2? And how to look at the problem? We project the vector of x onto x y plane. Here, for example, this is our projection, t x, and then we also look at the projection of w of w in x y plane. So this is our projection of W and we have that Tx will be moved to Tw in the xz xy plane. This is in the xy plane, and the value of theta will be the same with the value of angle to move x from become w. Okay, it means that our W1 and W2 will be the same with the rotation in two dimension. This is cos theta, this is sine minus sine theta, and this is sine theta, and the last is cos theta. This is x and y. Okay, and combine all of this result, W3 is equal to Z. So combine it, become three dimension. We have W1, W2, and W3 will be cos theta minus sine theta. This is will be zero. This is sine theta. This is will be cos theta, and this is will be zero. And the third line will be 0, 0, 1, and this is x, y, z. Okay. Yes. Okay. I will show it to you later how to use GeoGebra. And this is the standard matrix of rotation effectors around the z-axis. So we have in the third line, in the third row. This is the standard matrix rotation counterclockwise about z-axis. And you can do the same way like this for the rotation about x-axis and rotation about y-axis. In x-axis, it means that you must rotate it around x-axis, and you also make a rotation around y-axis. And this is the formula to rotate around x-axis, and this is the formula to rotate around y-axis. You have a standard metric. The pattern will be the same, cosine and sine, but there is an exception in the around y-axis. The minus not in the above, but in the in the third line, yeah. The pattern minus sign and sign, but in this case, sign and minus. Okay, I know the rotation operator is most difficult than rather than others. You must be careful and do some memorization. You must memorize some formula in this operator. And look at this exercise. In the previous exercise, we determine the standard matrix for linear transformation. And in the this exercise, we determine the standard matrix also, but for linear operators, which is defined by vector expansion in R2, and with the vector key is equal to 3. I hope this is easy for you. The standard matrix will be 3, 0, 0, 3, yeah. Only put key as 3. Okay. I hope you understand it well. And vector rotation in 3 dimension clockwise. Clockwise to the angle 60 degree respect to the axis X. Axis X, you must memorize, yeah, based on the previous explanation. This standard matrix will be, X-axis. X-axis mean that the first line will be 100, and this is will be follow the pattern of rotation in two dimension. This is must be cosine theta, this is minus sine theta. And this will be sine theta. Oh, sorry, sine theta, and this is will be cosine theta. Cosine theta. Okay. Because the rotation clockwise, so our angle must be negative. Must be negative, So we have that we must put minus 60 degree in cosine and sine. So it will be 100 and 0. This is will be cosine minus 60 degree. I will make it the formula and in B, yeah. B will be 0 cos cosine theta minus sine theta, 0 sine theta cosine theta, 100. Okay, so then we put theta minus 60 degree. So the standard matrix will be 0 cosine minus 60 degree, and this is minus sine minus 60 degree, and this is 0 sine minus 60 degree, and cosine minus 60 degree. This is 100. Okay, after we put the angle is minus 60 degree, we must know the property of sine or sinus. Sine minus x in will be minus sine x. This is the property of trigonometry. Trigonometry. So cosine minus x will be cosine x. The minus is disappear. And it's why by using these properties, we will have that 1 sorry, I will make in the second cosine 60 degree, and this is plus, yeah, minus minus become plus sine 60 degree, and this is 0 minus sine 60 degree, and this is cos 60 degree. It's 0, 0. After we have angle of cos and sine, we must know the value of sine 60 degree will be a half square root of 3, isn't it? And cosine 60 degree is a half. Okay. Then our answer will be 0, 0. This is a half, and sine 60 degree will be a half square root of 3, and this is 0 minus a half square root of 3, and this is a half. The 100. So this is the answer of 1B. It means that you must memorize the standard matrix, and after that put the value of parameter in this case the value of theta. And don't forget about the agreement counterclockwise and clockwise. Okay. Do you understand what I mean about rotation in 1B? Okay, no problem. Hello? Hello, do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, how to use, you must know the axis, you must know the angle, and you must know counter or anti-clockwise or clockwise. This information will make more will affect your result, yeah, for clockwise angle and axis. Okay, I will continue with the problem two. Determine the mirror from the factor -1,2, which is reflected respect to the line y is equal to x. We know that the reflection to the line y is equal to x, the standard matrix of them is 0, 1, 1, 0. Yeah, this is the standard matrix of a reflection about the line w, the line y is equal to x. And the reflection or the mirror of factors will be y w1 w2 and this is 0 1 1 0 multiplied by -2 and 2. Okay, we have that this is 2 and this is -1. So the answer of number 2 is factors 2 -1. So the mirror of -1,2 is 2, -1.
So why it's so? Is it because it's not x equal y but y equal to x? I mean, why it's flipped? It's not like the usual one in the projection operator, so.
In this case, so we talk about reflection. Yeah, we talk about reflection. Mirror, it means that reflection, not projection. As I talked before, that there are a lot of projection and there are a lot of reflection. In this lecture, we limit our discussion only reflection about line y is equal to x. But in the projection, we don't talk about this line. Yeah, only because of limitation of our discussion. For reflection and for projection.
So if mirror, we always need to flip it. So.
In this.
Yeah, if it's about mirror.
Mirror, flip. You can say the same way. We have one point and then other point is the mirror about x-axis like this. Then if you one point here and your mirror is y, so your shadow will be in this position. This is a reflection or flip. You can say flip also. No problem. Okay, then we will talk in this in the last question. Find orthogonal orthogonal projection. So we have that there are three kinds of orthogonal projection onto XY plan, untuk XZ plan, untuk YZ plan. In this case, untuk XZ XY plan. And here the situation we have XYZ, and this is our plan, XY plan, XY plan, and our factors X will be projection, orthogonal projection untuk XZ XY plan. XY. So this is our TX or W vector W. And as we know before, we have X, Y, Z here, and the orthogonal projection will have X, Z, X, Y, zero. Yeah, X, Y, zero. Z will be zero. So we can do like this because we must do by using standard matrix, yeah, 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0. This is our standard matrix to orthogonal projection untuk XY plan. This is XYZ, and we can replace it minus two. Minus 2, 1, and 3, and we will have that minus 2, 1, and 0. You can multiply 0, 0, 0 in the third line with the minus 2, 1, 3, we will have 0. This is simply by using that minus 2, 1, 3, become minus 2 1 0. Yeah, you can simply it without using the standard matrix. If you understand this concept, isn't it? Yeah, you must understand this concept, and you can simply that the your factor become minus 2, 1, 0. Z will be 0. Okay. We have done exercise 6.2. And okay, we will make a composition. Composition means that we have more than one linear transformation. The definition is like this: if we have two linear transformation, T1 and T2, and we have transformation T1 from Rn to Rk. And T2 from RT to RM. So what about the formula from RN to RM? Get it? So like this, we have T1 T1 is RN to RT. This is T1, and from R key, we make T2 R key to RM. This is to T2. So what about RN to direct to RM? How to find the formula from RN direct to RM? So this is the formula. It means that we must do T1 first. After that, we follow with the T2. So X must be done by T1 first, and after that done by T2. So the matrix, the standard matrix will be X must be multiplied by A first, after that multiply by B. So you can look at that the position of matrix, the standard matrix refers to the sequence of linear conformation. If you have T1 and followed by T2, and the standard matrix will be B times A. This is representation of T1, and B is representation of T2. This is how we find the formula to Rn direct to Rn by using the multiplication of B times A. Okay, so what about we have three composition, three linear transformation. For example, we have T1 from Rn to Rk, and T2 from Rk to maybe Rt, Rs maybe, and the T3 from R, sorry, this is not equal, this is must be T3 from Rs to Rm, and we want to find the formula from Rn direct to Rm. And the formula say that T3 from the composition of T3, T2 and T1 will be the multiplication of C, B and A, yeah. C, B and A, where A is a representation of T1, B is representation of T2, and C is representation of T3. Yeah, no matter how many linear transformation involved, you just follow this formula. The first become the last, the last become the first, yeah, the first position. T1 followed by T2, and the formula will be B times A. T1 followed by T2, followed by T3, and the formula will be C, B, then and A. Yeah, this is the composition. Okay, now how to do the composition? The exercise 6.3 explain how to do the composition. The first, we must write the standard matrix for each linear operators. We must know what is the operators. Like this, we have rotates effectors counterclockwise or about the z-axis. Z-axis, we have, so rotate z-axis, yeah, axis and counterclockwise. We have counterclockwise, the symbol of counterclockwise like this, and angle is pi divided by 2. Okay, this is the standard matrix for these operators. Will be Z will be 0, 0, 1, yeah, as rotation in three dimension, one of line must be 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. And Z axis will be 0, 0, 1. And the rest of the line will follow the formula in the rotation two dimension. This is must be cosine theta. This is must be minus sine theta. And this is must be sine theta. And this is cosine theta. And 0, 0, 1. This. And we put pi divided by 2 in this in the angle. We have that cosine pi divided by 2 90 degree. This is minus counterclockwise. We must put positive angle. So sine pi divided by 2. This is sine pi divided by 2. And sorry. And this is cos pi divided by 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. And we must know the value of cos pi divided by 2 is equal to 0. And sine pi divided by 2 is equal to 1. So the matrix rotation will be 0, minus 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. This is our matrix for rotation. Okay, then reflection, followed by reflection. Okay, plan YZ. We must know the standard matrix. Plan YZ, the value of X will be minus x, yeah, value of x will be minus x. So this is minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Yeah, the value of x will be because we reflect x here. X here in the for onto YZ plane. So X Y Z will be minus X Y Z. So this is our standard matrix. And then projecting, yeah, projecting vector orthogonally onto xy plane. Projection onto plane xy. The projection say that if we projection orthogonally onto plane xy, our z will be zero. So this is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 0. Okay, we have all of the three standard matrix for number one. Then our standard matrix for all of them, our for the composition will be 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0 multiplied by -1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, and the third we will have 0, -1, 0, 1, 0, 0, and 0, 0, 1. Okay, and to multiply it, you can use symbol lab. Yeah, you can use symbol lab to find the result. Yeah, to find the result, I multiply this this matrices. There are three matrices, and you can use symbol lab to multiply this. Okay. Yeah, of course, we just need to multiply it like usual. But to make it simple, you can use symbol lab make it faster to compute this multiplication. Maybe the composition more than three, so you will have matrix more than three also. Okay, I think this is how to find the composition of linear transformation. Is there any question? Okay, let me do the second question. Determine the reflection of vector 2, -5, which is rotated clockwise at an angle pi divided by 6, followed by a contraction by a factor p is equal to 1/2. Okay, reflection. A reflection. So you must make it one by one. Reflection. X axis or y axis here. Okay, we add this one about about X axis, yeah. Axis. So reflection X axis. This is a two dimension. We have X axis. Y will be negative. So 1, 0, 0, -1. Okay. And rotate clockwise. Rotate clockwise at an angle pi divided by 6. So rotate, rotate theta pi divided by 6. Then clockwise, yeah, clockwise. So the standard matrix will be cos minus 60 minus sine minus 60 and cos sine 60 and sorry, so this is sine and this is cosine minus 60. So you will have cos 60, yeah, the property of cosine. This is sine 60 and minus sine 60 and cosine 60. And then we know the value of cosine 60, a half minus a half square root of 3. This is a half square root of 3 and a half. Okay. Then followed by contraction. Contraction, you will know that this is easy, yeah. E is equal to a half, so the matrix is a half, 0, 0, a half. And your answer is a half, 0, 0, a half, multiplied by a half square root of 3 minus a half square root of 3, a half, and multiplied by 1, 0, 0, -1. Okay, let's multiply them and you can get the result. Yeah, you must know the standard matrix each of them. After that, you multiply all of the standard matrix in the reverse position. The first become the last become the first. Okay, yeah. This is the composition, yeah. The composition of linear transformation. Okay, now we will discuss for the last topic. In the last topics, we will talk about inverse linear transformation. If we have a linear transformation and standard matrix A, inverse of linear transformation, inverse of T, will have the matrix, the standard matrix inverse of A. So sorry, 60 or Yeah, you are right. Thank you. All right. Yeah, you are. Thank you. Pi divided by 6 is 30. Yeah, so 30 is, I think, to fix it. This must be 50 and so be yes, things. This is 50 and 50. Yeah, is that it? 50 and 50, 50, and this is square root of 3 here, of half. Minus the half, the half, the half, square root of 3. So this is, and here, yeah. Okay, thank you, Rikita. Then we, talk about inverse say that our inverse of linear transformation will have a standard matrix is inverse of a standard matrix of T. So we will have inverse if inverse of A exists. If inverse of A exists. If we do not have inverse of A, it means that our linear transformation will not have inverse. Like this, we have A will be 1 minus 2, 2, 2, 1, 1. 1 1 0. So the standard matrix of inverse transformation, linear transformation, means that we must know inverse of A. So we must find the inverse of A. This is standard matrix of standard matrix. Of inverse, yeah, it simplified by find the inverse of A. We must check it because might be the inverse of A is not exist. So we must check it before inverse it. Okay, you can find it by using a symbolet to find inverse of this matrix. Then second, determine a vector whose mirror is under linear transformation T is 1 minus 2 minus 2 0. Okay, the problem say that okay, this problem using question number 1 as the linear transformation. So the problem state like this. We have the result 1 minus 2, 0. This is the mirror under the linear transformation, or this is the result. And the matrix will be 1 minus 2, 2. 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. And we will find what is x1, x2, and x3. This is how we answer the question. So this is our problem. How to find factors such that their mirror is 1 minus 2, 0. And it means that we can find the value of x1, x2, and x3 by using inverse, yeah, both sides multiplied by inverse of A. So we will have that x1 will be can be found found by multiplication minus A inverse of A multiplied by 1 minus 2 0. So basically the question number 2 using inverse of linear transformation. Yeah, as I told you before, you can find A inverse of A by using symbol lab. And after you find it, please put it in this position and multiply it by 1 minus 2. And this is the result. Okay. Determine the standard matrix for inverse linear operators, if any, which are defined successively by vector reflection, and contraction. Okay, how to do that? The first, we can find each of this standard matrix vector reflection. In by the plan xy, it means that z should be 0, yeah, 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0, yeah, this is the reflection by the plan xy, and the reflection by xz, it means that 0 1 0 0, and y will be 0, so 0 0 0 and 0 0 1. Okay, this is the reflection by plan xz, and contraction by factors a fifth, then we have that the fifth. This is, and the last is like this. Okay, and don't forget about the multiplication of this composition. The composition will should be a fifth here, a 0 0, 0 0 0. Minus z in sorry. Yeah, you write again. Sorry, I have a confusion. I make a confusion. What we call orthogonal projection. Yeah, so we, yeah, okay, this one. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you again. Yeah. Like this. Lalu kita.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then you must multiply it in the reverse position. Reverse position, you will have. Yeah, you will have a few 0 0 here, and multiplied by the second 1 0 0 minus 1 0 one, and the last will have 1 0 and here like this, yeah, and then you will have the matrix of composition. After that, you inverse you must inverse this matrix. You must inverse this matrix to answer the question number 3. So this is the inverse. Yeah? Okay. Maybe we call it A, and A inverse to be our answer. Don't forget, you might have inverse or not inverse, not invertible. Yeah. You can maybe the inverse is not exist, or maybe the inverse is exist. Okay, I think you can do the rest by using symbolic multiplied by three matrices, and then after you get the matrices, call it A, and make the inverse of A, and this is the your answer, the standard matrix for inverse linear operators, which is defined successively by three operators. Actually, there are a lot of problems in Padlet, but we have no times, and I hope you can do it by yourself to make the preparation for assignment 6 in the next week. Yeah, the next week in the Padlet, I have put many problem in the Padlet. Please do this exercise to make you master in this linear transformation. There are a lot of problems. If you find difficulties to solve this problem, don't bother to ask me how to find the solution. Please text me if you have something. Okay, you still have the question for GeoGebra, isn't it? Okay, I will show it you. Actually, GeoGebra not to solve, but to only to illustrate. Okay, I will show you how to. This is GeoGebra. you can what can I show you? The calculation I think we must download it in the this is only simple form, yeah, not complete form of GeoGebra. We must download it to have complete form. Usually I use this one, GeoGebra Classic 6 and GeoGebra or GeoGebra Classic 7 and by using it we have a more complex feature in this GeoGebra. For graphing calculator is simplest application of GeoGebra. I will try to show you later, Lukita, because we are in the end of the meetings. I will show you, or maybe I will send you some screenshot how to use GeoGebra, how to explain linear transformation. We are in the end of meeting. Thank you guys to attend this class, and I remind you to make a presence in the M Ubaya. Don't forget to present yourself in the My Ubaya, M Ubaya, sorry, M Ubaya. Have a nice day, and see you in the next week. And stay safe, and good morning all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
There is a question.
It's an assignment, sir, for assignment 6.
Next week.
Next week. So this week we don't have any assignment.
This material, and the next week will be the material for assignment 6.
Okay.
I will send you the link of YouTube for this material.
Oh yes, so next week is holiday, right? I just remember, so.
Yeah, next week.
So it's after the holiday, is it so?
Yeah, after holiday. In the, not next week, yeah. Next week we will be holiday, but after holiday we will have thirteen weeks in after holiday, and the assignment 6 in the 13 week.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome. Okay, see you next meeting. Sorry, not next week, but not.